Welcome to the Tabletop Simulator tutorial series. I'm Kimiko with Berserk Games, and this tutorial series will go over all the different tools, custom content, and the various things you can do in Tabletop Simulator. This first video will focus on the basic controls and movement. Before you begin playing around in Tabletop Simulator, I highly recommend to try out the tutorial in-game. It goes over the very basic controls, but can give you a general idea of how it works. There are a lot of controls in Tabletop Simulator to learn and master, and this is because we offer a lot of tools that you can use to create some amazing things. So while it may seem overwhelming at first, you will soon become a pro and be able to help others who are just starting out as well. All of the info I'm going over can be found in the Help menu in-game, which you can bring up by pressing the question mark key on your keyboard, or the button next to the Enter key if you are not using a US keyboard. You can also find more in-depth info in our knowledge base on our website, which will be posted in the description below. Additionally, most controls can be found in the contextual menu, which you can bring up when you right-click on an object. Now let's get started! You can move your camera with either the keyboard, mouse, or even a mixture of both. By default, you are in third-person mode. The general camera movement is with the WASD keys, which enables you to move forward, back, and side to side. To rotate your camera around, you would hold and press your right mouse button. To pan your camera around, just press and hold your middle mouse button. To reset your camera position to default, press the space bar. If you want to quickly zoom in onto something, move your mouse to that location and press either your middle mouse button once or the Z key. Press again to return to your original spot. You can also move the scroll wheel of your mouse front and back to zoom in and out. This lets you control how close or far you want your camera to be. If you press the P key, that will toggle your camera to first person mode. The keys we previously pressed will now work a little bit differently. W and S will now move you in and out, A and D will still move you side to side, the right mouse button will rotate your camera, but you'll want to do it in combination with WASD to be effective. The control key will move you down, and the space bar will move you up. The middle mouse button will still pan your camera around. If you press P once more, you will now be in the top-down view. The settings are the exact same for top-down view and third-person, but top-down view allows you to see everything from directly above, which makes this easy for placing objects in the exact spot you want them to be. Now that we have the camera controls out of the way, let's try picking stuff up. Hover over an object and you will see it highlight. That's how you know that piece is active and you'll be able to modify it in some way. You will also see your pointer change based on what action you do. So hovering over it will make your hand open up. Press and hold your left mouse button to pick an object up. Let go to drop it. Picking up an object will make your hand close like you're holding it. To pick up multiple objects, while holding the first one, hover over a second object until it is highlighted, and then press down on your right mouse button. You can do this as many times as you'd like. If you want to pick up even more objects, you can box select them by clicking and holding your left mouse button anywhere on the table and dragging around the objects. You can see all those pieces are now highlighted. Pick up one of the objects and all that were highlighted will be picked up as well. With dice, you can either hold the dice, shake it and throw it, or if you want to do things a bit more calmly, you can hover over the die and press the R key multiple times. The R key can be used for both rolling the dice and raising objects higher if you're holding them. Another cool feature is if you need to pick the number of the die manually, you can do so without having to pick it up. Just hover over the die and then press any number combination. In this case, I'm just going in consecutive order, but you can see how the die is moving to the number that I have pressed. You can flip an object a couple of ways. While holding an object, press the middle mouse button or the F key. Or you can hover over an object and press the F key to flip something that you aren't holding on to. For rotating objects, hold the object and scroll with your middle mouse button or with the Q and E keys. Or you can hover over an object and use the Q and E keys to rotate them while they are on the table. Now let's get a deck of cards. A great feature that comes in handy is being able to zoom in on a specific object. To do this, just hover over an object and press and hold the Alt key. Now the object you have alt-zoomed is magnified so you can see what's on it. This is great for cards or any object that is farther away and you don't feel like moving your camera around. You can zoom in even closer if you need to see more details while alt-zoomed. Just scroll with the middle mouse button to zoom in and out. You can also use the Q and E keys to rotate the object if you need to see it in a different direction. The contextual menu is great if you don't want to worry about any hotkeys, as you can do just about anything here, and the menu changes depending on what you click on. The top part of the menu will always apply to that object type. Most notably, cards will have extra options like shuffling and dealing, and dice will have options like rolling and setting to a specific number. Play around with it and see all the nifty things you can do. You can find more about it in the knowledge base. We will go over the contextual menu in a future video. A couple more things with basic controls. You can quickly duplicate or delete objects by using the hotkeys Ctrl-C to copy, Ctrl-V to paste, and Ctrl-X to cut or delete the object. Additionally, you can delete objects by just pressing the Delete key on your keyboard. And that's going to wrap up this video about the basic controls and movement in Tabletop Simulator. The next video will go over the advanced controls, which may just cover some things even you veterans were not even aware of. So stay tuned and see you next time!